Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Upasana Gosalia, and today we are going to be discussing something which is not so talked about, not that common, and that is things you need to know before getting braces. In my practice, I have often seen and noticed that once the orthodontic or braces treatment starts, patients come back to us asking questions like, oh, I didn't know this was going to be done. Oh, I didn't know this was going to happen. So that's what got me thinking that this is a little less spoken about topic, and so many of you are not aware of what actually goes on and what to expect when you're having braces. So that's what we are going to be discussing today in this video. Before I begin today's video, I want to tell you guys that I'm not here trying to discourage you or scare you away from braces, because believe me, braces is a blessing when it comes to bite corrections and alignment corrections, etc. It's one of the most frequently recommended treatments to all patients by us dentists. It can really change your aesthetics, your jaw alignment, your smile, and all of that. So what I'm trying to do here today in this video is just have you guys a little more well aware about what to expect when your braces treatment is on, and to answer some frequently asked questions. Before I begin talking about braces, a big shout out to all my viewers and subscribers. Thank you for sending in so much love and asking so many questions. I know most of you would have subscribed to my channel, but if you haven't and you're new, please do hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for regular updates. The first thing that you guys need to know before getting your braces treatment started is you might have to extract or remove a few teeth. If some of you were aware about this, great. But if you weren't, I'll try to explain why this is required. Now, most likely the tooth that we prefer to remove are the premolars. These are the teeth situated behind your canines. Now, why do you actually require to extract these teeth, if you want to know? That is because we want some space. We want to generate space in your arches, both your upper and lower dentition, because we would like to correct the alignment of the teeth. Or maybe if your teeth are forwardly placed, we want to get them a little more backward or retroclined. So in such situations, it becomes essential to have some space generation, and we achieve this by extracting a couple of teeth in both arches, two in the upper and two in the lowers. Now, the second thing that you need to know before getting your braces started is that you will take some time to get used to it. What do I mean by, get used to it? Firstly, see, you're going to salivate a lot, because braces, either the metallic or the ceramic ones, either one of them, they are like a foreign body in your mouth. Your mouth was not used to them for all this while. So when we put these braces on, your body naturally, as a physiological response, starts to excrete more and more saliva. And that might be a little difficult to deal with initially, but then this process gradually slows down. Also, your lips feel a little fuller. You might feel that you suddenly have that pouty smile. Your lips are constantly outside because your brackets are placed on the front surface of the teeth, which kind of increases the gap between the tooth and the lip. Also, your speech is going to be a little altered. And what I mean by that is, usually when we speak, it's all our tongue touching the internal surfaces or the inner surfaces of the teeth, our lips coming together to make sounds like p, b, m. All these are going to take a little while to get used to, but there's nothing to worry about, because your body really adapts, your mouth really adapts very quickly. So initially, 2 to 3 weeks, you might sound different because you're salivating excessively. The sounds are coming a little different, but then it all settles in a while. The third thing. It is normal to get blisters and ulcers while your orthodontic period is on, or rather I would say in the very initial phase of your braces treatment. What happens is, despite of increased salivation in your mouth, every time you eat or speak, there's a constant abrasion or rubbing between the metal or the brackets and the inner surface of your mouth. And this abrasion gives rise to typical blisters. Now, these can be easily avoided if you take care of a few things, like have a lot of water. You can use glycerin to keep the areas moist. Another very easy thing that you can do for these ulcers is using dental wax. Now, this comes in really handy. The orthodontist will most likely give you a piece of wax, which is to be used on the areas or the brackets which are giving you that blister. All you have to do is make a ball and just push that wax onto the bracket so that the friction or the rubbing mechanism is kind of eased out for a bit. if you're thinking whether this is something which is going to recur, is it going to happen throughout the period of the dental treatment, then no, that's not the case. This probably might just happen for the initial 2 or 3 months. That's it. The fourth thing that I want to discuss is food. What to eat, what not to eat. We get these questions very, very commonly. Yes, I'd like to say that there are a few restrictions when it comes to food when you have your braces on. We as dentists like to, you know, ask our patients to avoid very sticky or very hard foods, and that includes like popcorn, caramel, chewing gums, very hard nuts, thin crust pizzas, and quite a few more. And you can't even bite into things like an apple, you know, straight away. You need to understand why we have put up these restrictions when it comes to food. Sticky food like caramel, popcorn, etc., they are extremely difficult to clean, especially if you have braces on. They are most likely going to get lodged in all these areas between your braces and the teeth, and then you're going to start having cavities, which is very difficult to deal with. And secondly, food that is very hard has sometimes, you know, seen to cause damages or brackets breaking and debonding from the tooth surface. Now, this is not really a complication per se. It's very easy. We can fix the bracket back. But what you need to understand is every time a bracket debonds or it gets off the tooth because of something that, you know, you were supposed to avoid but you had. So what happens is we are only delaying your treatment. We are going back into your treatment by a couple of months. Your wire needs to be changed again and replaced to probably the earlier one or the one even before that. So we are here talking about going back 2 to 3 months. That means a delayed time period for completing the dental treatment and of course the added expenses as well. So what I would suggest is, if you're not somebody who can, you know, stay away from those pizzas and apples, etc., all you have to do is just make small pieces of the food that you want to have. Or maybe, you know, if you're trying for nuts or something, you can have them semi-grinded and just use a spoon or a fork and place them directly on your back teeth or the molars. Don't let them get in touch with your front teeth and don't try to break into them or bite into them. This will certainly give rise to some bracket breakages. Now, the fifth thing. Brushing with braces. Okay, I know that brushing with braces is very, very difficult. Maintaining a good oral hygiene when you have braces on is difficult, but I think it's something that you should not neglect. Having a good oral hygiene ensures that the gum health or the periodontal health is good, and this in turn helps us to achieve your tooth movements in a timely manner, finish your treatment in the given time period. So by maintaining good oral hygiene, you're just doing your bit to help us dentists complete your treatment in the given time period. So basically what I'm trying to imply here is, if you don't maintain good oral hygiene, you can expect that your treatment does get postponed or delayed for a bit, because your gum health is not going to be very ideal to move the teeth and your appointments keep getting further and further delayed. Now, how do you achieve a good oral hygiene? So there are special orthodontic brushes that your orthodontist will suggest you to use. But apart from these brushes and brushing twice a day, of course, for a minimum of 2 to 3 minutes, you need to use an additional aid, which is called as an interdental brush. Now, this brush has to be used in this manner, you know, in between your existing braces and the wire and your tooth surfaces, and it has to go in and clean out all the dirt from everywhere. I know it's a little time consuming, and initially you'll feel like you're doing a lot for your teeth, but once you get the hang of it, it's going to be a very quick and easy job. For those of you who are hooked on to maintaining great oral hygiene and flossing daily, I must tell you that with your braces on, flossing can be quite a task. It's not impossible, but at the same time, it is extremely, extremely difficult to let your floss pass through under the wire and then between your teeth. So alternatively, what you can do is invest in a good water flosser. What is this water flosser? These are basically battery operated or, you know, electrical plug-in devices, and these generate a jet or a stream of water which is pushed between your tooth surface. And what this does is it literally flushes out or cleans the interdental surfaces or the surfaces between two teeth as well. It's a very good investment if you're going to be having braces for a long period of time, like 1 year to 2 years. And it's very easily available online or even in stores. If you guys are not able to find it, then I have left a link in the description box for Amazon. You can easily buy it online from there. Now, the sixth thing that I want to talk to you about, or rather, this is one of the most frequently asked questions to me when it comes to braces, and that is, will it hurt? Will it pain if I have my braces on? See, this is a very tricky question because pain thresholds are different for different individuals. But if you ask me, I would say that this is a mostly pain-free procedure. A major chunk of our patients who are getting orthodontic treatment or braces, they are in the age group of, you know, like their teens, 13 to 16, and they are able to deal with this pain very easily. At the most, what we've had to do for a few cases where they feel that the pain is too much for them to bear, we give them some painkillers to take for a day or two, and that's about it. With braces, what typically happens is there's a lot of pressure built on your teeth because we are trying to shake or move the teeth from their existing position into a new desired position. So that pressure sometimes gives rise to a little bit of pain. The beauty is that with every passing day, the pressure also reduces slowly and thus your pain reduces. So initially, for a couple of months when the treatment is new for you, you might feel that pressure or a little pain. But once you get a little more into the treatment and your teeth have moved a little bit, then it kind of eases out. The further monthly appointments or the tightening appointments are not really very painful. And the last thing that I want to talk to you about is retainers. Now, what are retainers and why should they be used? Actually, this is a very vast topic. It calls for a video in itself. If you guys want to know more about it, please leave it in the comments below and I'll try to make a separate video on it. But for now, what I want to say is a lot of times patients are unaware that once their braces are off, like once their stipulated period of 1.5-2 years is over and we've removed those braces, they're unaware that we have to put in something called as a retainer. What is this retainer? It's basically just an appliance that we use to hold the teeth in the given or the current new position. If we fail to do that, or if we don't give you a retainer, your teeth tend to fray out a bit or move in some different positions and we lose the desired result that we have achieved. So in order to hold on to that, we give patients retainers, and the typical time period I would say would be in the range of 9 months to a year. Now, these retainers are broadly classified into removable and fixed. Both serve the same purpose, but they're just, you know, different in use and to look at. A common problem that we've seen patients face after their braces treatment is over is that, you know, children just tend to become a little more complacent. They forget all the instructions given by their dentist on how many hours to wear the retainer, when to use it, when not to use it, and all that. And then they tend to come back to us after a few years saying that I'm not happy with how my teeth look now. They were good when the braces treatment ended, but now they look a little bit different. So I think this is one of the most important steps and you guys should not miss out on this. You can discuss with your orthodontist as to which is the ideal retainer for you, should you opt in for the fixed one or the removable one. And of course, there are cost variations in both as well. But what you must not forget or must not do is to avoid wearing them. I hope I've been able to throw some light on what to expect while you're having braces. If you guys have any questions pertaining to braces or anything else, please do leave them in the comments below and I'll try my best to answer them all. And as I say always, stay healthy and keep smiling.